Mr. Rakesh and our fellow friends. Today I'm going to talk about strategic marketing planning for Gardenia Bakeries. So Gardenia is the leading bakery brand in Malaysia since the 1990s, as we all know. And it has 60% of market share in Malaysia. It is the market leader in Malaysia. It has a wide range of products. They have breads, buns, and also wholemeal breads. One thing about Gardenia is they don't use artificial preservative, but instead they use the natural replacement. Okay, next. So this is the BCG matrix, as you can see. So product cycle, Gardenia is in the maturity stage. As we all know, it's a very established brand in Malaysia. It's very good experience in the bakery industry. So this is the pest analysis. For politics part, they have to consider about the import tax and also the GST while implementing their price of their products. For economics, they have inflation, the exchange rate, and also the decreasing purchasing power. They have to consider about this also when they produce new products and also when they charge new price for their new products. Next. So for the social factor, they have to be aware of the spending power of the consumers in Malaysia, also the lifestyle and demographics of the people here. For the technology, they have to be very constantly updated about the online culture in Malaysia, because as we all know, people are now very focused on websites and also social media. And so they have to use the new technologies to produce their breads in order to be keep updated in the market. So for the legal factor, they have to think about the health and safety regulations, the standards, and also the employment rules. For the environment, they have to be aware about the customer attitudes, restrictions, and also the pollution towards the environment. Next. So this is the SWOT analysis. Strength is the most well-known brand, as I mentioned just now. It has a wide range of products. They have a reasonable price and also affordable to the people here. So for weaknesses, they are price-sensitive product. No standalone store, this is a very big disadvantage. Many substitute products and also no online services for this revenue. Next one for opportunity is they have a big room for market penetration. They have a fast market growth because Gardenia is very well known and they are constantly growing in the market. Next one is the continuous innovation of products. Okay, for threats, they have economic crisis in Malaysia. As we all know, the economy in Malaysia is really, really bad now. Next one is substitute product. They have many other competitors fighting with Gardenia right now. Also, their competitors are also reducing their prices, so this is a very big disadvantage towards Gardenia Bakeries. So for mission, Gardenia aims to provide a variety of best quality, tasty, nutritious and enjoyable bakery to the people here. Next one is competitive advantage. They have a very good brand awareness, they have a wide group of loyal customers. Next one is they use natural substances instead of using the artificial preservative. So for the objective, they want to be globally recognized and also to build trust by selling high quality products to the people, and also to maintain the market leader position in Malaysia. This is very important towards their growth and also sales for Gardenia. So for water generation strategies, they are currently using the differentiation strategy. They have a very good strategy in differentiating themselves from their customers. One is the they have a wide range of products. The second one is the preservative thing. So for answer metric, I recommend them to use the market penetration and also market development. Market penetration is that they implement a lower price to get more customers and also to maintain the loyal ones. So next one is the market development. They use the existing products to penetrate the new market. So for the SDP for sanitation, demographics, they aim for kids aged 5 to 12, teenagers, young adults, adults and also old folks. Geographic, they aim for the people in the urban area in Malaysia. Next one is psychographic. For the lifestyle, they target people in the urban area, the sporty people and also people in the rural area. Okay, next one is the occasion. Depending on for what occasion they buy the Gardenia for, is it for charity event or a sporting event? Next one is interest and attitude. Maybe some people want to be on diet, so maybe they consume bakeries and buns for their meals. Next. So target market, target people, working adults, young adults, family with young kids, especially because young kids, they love to eat bun and so bread. And then elderly people also, they use braids because maybe some of them, their teeth are not functioning properly. That's why they're positioning. They offer a wide choice of maybe as an office with refreshment or quick breakfast. Rest of this, they are using the product line extension. They can put more products if they are not available in Malaysia. Next. Pricing strategy, they use the penetration strategy and also psychological strategy. Next one. Promotional tool, this is advertisement, they activate advertising, radio and so on the platform. Next one is public relations, they use social work, Twitch, Wagon and so on, break day. Next. Distribution strategy, they use intensive distribution strategy because for FMCG company, they do a wide distribution throughout Malaysia. Next one. Is the implementation plan. Next. The budgeting. The top two is the TV advertisement and also the social media. Next. Contingency plan. They are using the increasing marketing budget focus on social media platform. As we all know, people are now all focusing on social media. Next one is cost cutting. Maybe they can cut costs in their labor costs and also maybe their packaging and also the material used to package their products to cut costs in order to maintain their position and also their growth in the market. That's all for my presentation.
Okay, so appreciate. So you mentioned under weakness, the last point, no online services.
Yes.
So what is the issue here? I mean, what kind of services you're referring to?
Okay, maybe these online services, maybe they can create a website just for people to order their buns and breads online. Like other website, they have this service to order things like McDonald's, like other food. So maybe Gardenia can do this for people to order food and then they can deliver this to their home.
Do you think this is a good idea? Because usually their product are in the retailer's outlet or retailer might sell it online. If you directly sell bread online, do you think it's a good way? For every household eat bread, they might have millions of customers. Do you think it's a practical strategy?
Because not everybody, not to say not everybody, but maybe some of them are not really willing to go to the physical store. So maybe they have other emergencies or many other things to attend to. Maybe they want these online services to cater for them. So we aim for this type of people. I don't think this is to make profit, but instead we use this strategy to gain more trust in them, for them to think that we want to make them feel more convenient in their life. Because we maybe can use the motorcycle with the, not necessarily using the lorry, also when right, we can use the motorcycle, so it also save more costs.